brought to you by GTA. We start with you.
Say no to drugs. It's not worth it.
That's the message Robert Afaisen has for all in the community as he walked out of the district courthouse after his sentencing hearing. Afaisen pleaded guilty to retrieving over 12 kilograms of cocaine that washed ashore in May 2018. The court granted the minimal sentencing of 57 months or 5 years in federal prison. That was agreed upon by both parties and the U.S. Probation Office.
It's still harsher than we would like, but it's an unusual case with such a large amount of drugs.
Afaisen's attorney, federal public defender John Gorman, told the court that his client is not a drug dealer, saying in fact he is a terrible drug dealer, as it only took 3 weeks for Afaisen to be caught by the feds.
But as I said, I mean, the world's worst drug dealer. Yeah, I mean, he was sitting on his beach and all of a sudden a barrel full of drugs washes up. So he certainly isn't a professional drug dealer at all. He's made a wrong decision.
A wrong decision because ultimately he never turned in the 50-gallon barrel containing cocaine. Instead, he admittedly distributed the drugs. It was stated in court that he made a total profit of $1,000. Providing testimony, Afaisen told Chief Judge Francis Tidinko Gatewood that when the drugs came into his beach, he saw it as a gift after his 19-year-old son had passed away 3 months prior. He said he offered the drugs to people who came to him in need. Quote, I don't even know what my motivation was. Losing a child is the worst thing anyone could go through, end quote. He added, when it was washed up on shore, I thought I was the lucky one, but I was not the lucky one. Attorney Gorman also argued that the case is unique as no one knows where the drugs came from, who they were intended for, or how many barrels were found.
I mean, it is so tempting when something like that washes up because it potentially represents a huge amount of money, but you do have to turn it in because it's not going to work out well otherwise.
Although since the arrest, according to the pre-sentence investigation report, all drug tests have been negative, as noted in court that Afaisen was using meth from 2011 up until his arrest. And since then, Afaisen has cooperated fully. Attorney Gorman asked for 3 judicial requests. His client be allowed to self-surrender to U.S. Marshals, be placed in Sheridan, Oregon, and assessed for a drug abuse program. The court granted the request, did not impose a fine, and ordered a 4-year supervised release term after serving his jail sentence, along with 100 hours of community service.
I feel good. So, that's it.
Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Adriana Cotero.
Brought to you by GTA. We start with you.